creep on a bike.
Stop, and all this, like, a bunch of us just started, like, pointing at him and being like, oh, wait, that guy? Like, audibly, like, and he's like, went out. But yeah, no, all in all, I like Denver. It's new. You know, I grew up in New York City, so it's like, this is nowhere near. Yeah, like, so, I was born in Colorado. My dad left when I was like 2 or 3. Mom remarried to my stepdad, who then worked in New York, and my mom got a job with Lockheed Martin, of all places.
In the city?
In the city, and so we moved back there. I lived in the city for a while, like Brooklyn, Queens, and then Lane was born, needed a bigger house, so we moved to Long Island. And then like right after 9/11, I think is when we moved back out here, and yeah, no. And so, like, the one thing that I missed about being in the city, and I've been back here 17, almost 8 years, so it's like, I've mainly been here most of my life, you know? But, like,
but those younger years are
important. Yeah, like, just having the idea of, like, oh, I could leave my house at 2 a.m. when there'd be something going on. Or just, like, hearing, like, I tell some friends this, and they think it's the craziest thing, but hearing, like, some people, like a homeless dude, and like yelling, or just like somebody breaking bottles, or just like chaos. Ambulance is like, I don't know what it is, like, if it's like because I was so young growing up in the house, but like that kind of background noise is almost like a white noise machine for me. Like, and it's like sleeping through a thunderstorm. Because when we moved back out here from New York, it was so fucking quiet, like, that my sleep immediately changed. I was like, too quiet, which, like, I appreciate quiet now. But I don't know, but my main point after I just came down to the ramble was, I don't know, it is a little bit closer, a little bit more going on than, like, especially Lafayette.
I'm done. There's no way I can do
and I've just explored all the nooks and crannies of Boulder, and I barely know that.
And there's
really
a lot.
Yeah.
I mean, do you live around in this neighborhood?
In Capitol Hill? Clarkson. So I'm in Capitol, like, kind of
Capitol Hill, I feel like, is a different vibe than Uptown or Coors Field area. That area is very gross central. But, like, out over here, it's nicer. Jade and I live over here.
I wasn't really around here very much, so.
Yeah, no, that's how life works, right?
We broke up right when I moved here.
Really?
Yeah.
Did you move here for her or just
no? Yeah.
He showed you an interest.
Yeah, well, so like she was like, I would come and spend like a couple days or like a day, and it was like couples, and like sometimes like she would have to go do something for like 2 hours. And so I'd be like, well, fuck it, I'm gonna go walk around the city. Mm-hmm. And I just started exploring all this stuff and like going up and down alleys and stuff. And I was like, I really enjoy this.
Honestly, and Denver alleys are pretty cool.
I've literally furnished half my apartment with stuff.
Really?
Yeah, if you go like,
you find stuff everywhere. People just leave shit.
Because the richer neighborhoods are over that way, I believe. And so, yeah, like, it's crazy how much stuff people throw away.
And people hate in those. Whatever. I have a friend from high school. She paints all around Denver. It's really cool. She's always doing murals.
That's awesome.
And a lot of them are in alleys. They're super cool. No, oh, I'm so happy you're in Denver.
Yeah, no, it kind of was a good place for, because like when me and Brenna first started working.
I know. I love your guys' partnership. So
yeah,
cool.
I know. It's a Brenna's my platonic life partner.
I fucking love that.
Uh-huh.
She needs her.
How you doing?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm good.
I like good. The next day.
Have you guys been on the pool yet?
Yeah.
What are you looking for?
I was looking for the towel.
Does he? That's good.
I just cleaned it.
Do you need to clean one?
Send me a picture of it for him.
Yeah.
Yeah. Thank you.
Yeah.
I love your shirt.
Oh, thank you. I really like it too.
Summer, I found a place called Arc that might do scans and prints too.
Oh, nice. Yes.
I'll talk to you before.
Also, my... uncle, I guess. Sorry, I really have to think about that one. He is a graphic designer.
Oh, shit.
My mom went to like a housewarming party or whatever, and he was talking. My mom was talking about the art he was talking about, his graphic design. He offered to maybe help with that. I don't know if he has all the equipment, but...
He's a graphic designer. All he needs access to is Photoshop, and it'd be very weird if he didn't have Photoshop.
I think he does, and I think he has, like, the scanning equipment to do it as well.
I would have him do it just because...
Yeah.
You know how many semesters of graphic design classes I took? One.
My brother's a graphic designer, but he's kind of...
I dropped
out.
I am going to go ahead just because it's probably going to be a lot cheaper with like a family discount. No, definitely. Please do that. But we'll see. If I don't get that to work out, I'm definitely going to look into it. Are you doing print artwork? Yeah, trying to. Summer had some of her paintings.
I saw your Jesus painting.
Yeah,
that
thank you.
That one woman took or bought from you.
Yeah.
That one was cool. I like that one.
Yeah, I'm so glad people liked it.
Jesus definitely
would
have pulled, for sure.
Yeah.
Hell yeah.
But I'm trying to get prints out because a lot of people want like the same painting, and I'm like, it already has a home.
Oh, yeah.
One of my favorite and like best paintings is in her living room, and I'm like, I need to take it back and get it stamped. So I can do prints of it.
I know Brenna's been thinking of printing more stuff too. During like journals or notepads, or I feel like you could do a lot with your
cards.
Yeah.
So I'm like trying to do stickers and everything, hopefully.
Oh yeah, and stickers.
Start with some prints, see how they sell.
Yeah.
I think the prints will do well, especially.
Everyone loves prints.
Yes.
You know, they're so accessible.
Exactly.
What, are you getting a madam? Do you know what madam is? I think that's the right word. So it's basically, you remember, do you see like the little ones I brought? Last time, you know how it had that white frame?
My mom bought one from you.
Oh yeah,
that's true.
Yeah, I know. I traded her for carrots and she gave me $5.
Yeah.
All I wanted was
carrots. She's a sweetheart. She's like, no, it's not good enough.
I know, she was, I destroyed that bag of vegetables, by the way.
Like, she's so glad that she was like, I would have brought more if I knew he wanted them. Like,
I would give them to customers and stuff.
Oh, that's so nice.
Do you have a garden?
Yeah.
It's like enormous. It's crazy.
It's
really
the biggest garden I've ever seen.
I want to be
like in
thumb.
Somebody's yard. Yeah.
I never want to go to a grocery store again.
Yeah. Right. No, she doesn't really have to for produce.
Yeah. That's awesome.
Yeah. I mean, it probably isn't more cost efficient or anything, but it's definitely healthier.
Yeah. I freaking bet.
Yeah.
And better for the soil, too.
Yeah, exactly.
That's awesome.
Yeah, talk to your step-uncle, might know what matting is, but it's basically, it just makes that, it adds like a little nice frame and structure to it,
right.
You know, and then it just...
Yeah, I definitely think I want to do that.
Yeah.
I need to get, like, actually in touch with him instead of being like, I'm talking to him for my mother.
Yeah, no, of course. Because this is the big thing. It could be, humans are funny, right?
Yeah.
It could be the shittiest fucking quality thing, not like, you know, but if it looks nice and it's packaged well.
It's got nice quality. Paper.
Exactly. Yeah. People buy it. It doesn't matter. Like, it's like why, like, one thing I do when I'm from design school is like why Apple's packaging is so feels
because
nice when you open
products.
It. You know, it's like, I'm not going to talk about that.
No, I'm just kidding. I'm just kidding.
I'd be like an asshole.
I have one too,
yeah. But no, it's like, it just like adds quality and like, you know, when you frame like a painting, especially, that can quadruple the price.
Right.
So. Also, I have a massive frame. Do you know how big that Teletubbies painting is? Is it framed?
No. It's like, it was like 1 foot by 2 foot, or like 2.5 by, no, it's like 3.5 by 2.5.
I think that sounds right, yeah.
Okay.
I don't know, I'll have to measure it again.
Yeah, I'm not
so
sure.
I'll hit you up about it, because I found, once again, in an alley, coming full circle, I found a frame that I thought would fit one of my paintings, but it doesn't. And so, I'll hit you up on the internet.
For a canvas?
Yeah, it's for a canvas. It's like, just a really nice frame.
Yeah.
It's like super gaudy. And
fuck
like,
yeah.
Really
that
fun.
Would be great.
Awesome.
Yeah.
I just can't use it. Right now it's literally sitting like on my bathtub.
Yeah, definitely. I'll take it off your hands if it fits.
That'd be awesome.
Yeah, that's great.
Yeah.
I like almost
this is also
got
a nice
from a climb to a jasmine.
Just, like, oh,
nice.
Well, I kind of technically did,
like,
but
I don't know. I mean, I know a lot of these people now just because
I didn't make
of
it, but I did.
She's got a little cult following.
Yeah. Because this is actually like last week was like popping.
That's what she said.
Yeah. It's like Labor Day weekend.
I literally just need someone to kick me in the ass.
So, Brett, you just come back over here, come back here to like.
Oh. Booked a couple concerts at Red Rocks, which is why I came for this weekend.
Mm-hmm.
I'll actually be back again next weekend for a wedding.
Mm-hmm.
We're getting married.
You guys are a powerful duo. I don't know legally and morally how that would go.
Yeah.
But, you know.
Well, did you see her new shirt?
Oh, yeah, dude. I'm sure she told you, but, like, one of the wildest parts of that night is, like, I'm sitting there behind the booth, spaced out, and this nice young lady walk up. And I see, like, submissive and readable, but I kind of just, like, subconsciously read it. And I was like, oh, like, that sounds familiar. And I look at her more, and then Brenda just, like, figures out that this girl, like, bought one of her shirts.
Right.
And it was, like, the most surreal experience. Because I didn't even get hers.
Right.
Like, I think she got home, but it was, like, there was a lot of cool shit like that. Just, like, people that, like, TikTok following, you know, people just came. We had a big crowd for, like, the amount of stuff. Like, you know, because, like, the poll definitely brought a lot of traffic the first, like, round that I was on. Like, for that.
Especially her poll, so colorful.
Mm-hmm. And
people
just, like,
are, of course,
going to
stop.
Exactly. And, like, everybody being able to perform, and, like, because a lot of them, it's like, that was the first time performing to an audience. And there's, like, so many fucking people. But it was really cool, but I was like, okay, it's going to be a lot chiller. And in some ways it was, but, you know, Brenda's just such a, like, colorful character that I think people just kind of
gravitate to her.
Yeah. Because I would, like, walk away and then come back and there'd be, like, a full-blown, like, party going on at the booth. And I'm like, what the fuck is going on? Yeah, it was good. Yeah, one of those things. Every time too, I've almost watched her beat the shit out of you.
I've heard, which I love.
Right. Yeah. It was just like, if you play with the rollerblade dude, there was this dude at the first Friday, and I'm talking to Brenda about, like, some of the business stuff, having a conversation, and I'm, like, talking to her, and it feels like I'm a cartoon. I was just like, I looked over, and she was gone, and I looked over, and she was, like, in that like lime gray green, like, one piece, I believe.
Oh, with the snake on it?
Yeah, and there's, like, this drunk dude on rollerblades trying to get on the pool, and she was just like, and just, like, tosses this dude. And I was just like, damn, but it was just so funny. And then there's some dude saying some weird shit last, like, 2 days nights ago, like, on first Friday. None of those girls. None of those people. It's cool to see that.
It's like newfound empowerment, really.
Uh-huh.
That's how I feel. Like, this new wave of feminism is kind of cool.
No, it's very good.
Especially with more non-binary people. There's a lot of that.
Mm-hmm.
Do you have, what are your pronouns?
Him, I guess.
Yeah.
Like, I definitely don't, I've explored it, but I definitely have, like I can have my, like, feminine, I guess, like, maybe if anything, I'm fluid. Like, it's one of those things that, you know, I've definitely been thinking about it a lot more, being, like, because I dated somebody recently who's non-binary and is getting top surgery and stuff like that.
A lot of people are getting top surgery. Right. I love the look. I think it looks really cool.
Oh, yeah. No, and they're an amazing person, too. It just came, it was one of those things that I'd only known them for, like, maybe, like, 3 months, and it just became very apparent, because I was like, they were going through that, like, trying to make that decision, like, I think this is the next step, and, like, what I want to do with my body, and, like, who I am, my identity, gender, blah, blah, like, and so I was just like, it just became very apparent that, like, we both needed, like, they needed their space to, like, really, like, work with that and get those steps moving and stuff. So it was, like, honestly, like, as weird as this, probably the most beautiful breakup.
Brenna?
Remember
yes.
That?
That's nice.
Yeah, it is a very beautiful
breakup.
Very
nice.
Yeah. No, exactly. Very rare. And so, I still talk to them. Usually, like, when they, like, bring up somebody, I just, like, disappear out of their life for, like, a year. But that's probably just me being, like, a man-child.
Well, sometimes you need your space, too, you know?
Mm-hmm.
And life is long. Like, having a year apart from somebody is fine.
No, exactly. Because I don't want to hate anybody. I don't. But it hurts, you know?
Yeah.
And so, I need to remove myself from all sorts of... in this fucking song. I'm like trying to think, and I'm like, what is this? I'm like, but yeah, like, you know, if I see something that reminds me of the person, like, it'll trigger me in spiral, so I kind of have to just, like, you know, like disappear. And Lois Blair, like, we were friends before we, like, kind of got more romantic, so that was what was neat about it. It was, like, we had already built a strong foundation, and it was the first time, really, like, it was one of these things where it was, like, yeah, like, you know, like a human being, I like having sex, I like being cuddled, everybody wants to be, not everybody, but I like being held, I like to, like, you know, doing silly romantic stuff, thank you, I'm trying to think of the word, because
yeah,
it's and, but, like, with Claire, like, it was kind of like, oh, like, this is, it was weird, it wasn't, like, awkward weird, but it was, like, I think, like I said, from the get-go, there was always just, like, you know, we had, like, a romantic thing for a little bit, but it was always more just a friendship, and I think that is what kind of benefits us now, in the sense that I can actually, because, like, other than Brenna, Claire is, like, I mean, I've made friends and know people out here, but, like, Claire and Brenna are, like, the only two people I hang out with, and, you know, because, like, Taylor and everybody, I could try to get them out here, but it's, like, once every 2 months, you know?
Although I heard Paxton was, Paxton was here. She was at First Friday.
Yeah.
And I think Taylor was there last
month. He was. That was the one that he
came. He was on the pole.
Yeah, I know. I still haven't seen that video. I may have satellite video. That was really awesome. Because him, Josh, and Jacob all came.
So they're all three living together, right?
Yeah, yeah. It's a very funny house. It looks exactly like their boarding house here.
Yeah. I think I've been to it once.
Yeah, you have. I think I remember having a conversation in, like, the studio space.
Yeah, yeah. His studio is pretty cool.
Right?
He seems to be, like, very successful.
Yeah, he's doing it.
Thank you, Becca.
It's like, he kind of lives with the same philosophy I do, where, like, I don't know, like, I want to make money off my art and do what I want to do, and that's what you have to do, too, like, music. And so, like, a lot of our older friends kind of get weird with us sometimes. Like, oh, you don't hang out with us anymore. Woo! It's like, clearly, I'm going to be 30 in less than I turned 29 in, like, what day is it?
You Virgo?
Yeah, in 14 days, 2 weeks.
Happy birthday.
Thank you.
Woohoo, 29.
29, yeah. And so it's like, a lot of people, like, get weird about that. Like, oh, like, you're bailing on your friends. It's like, no. Like, I love you guys, and I'll always love you, but I also realize that I don't want to smoke weed every day and play video games until I'm 30. I want to be able to make money off my art. And moving to Denver has, opportunity-wise, my art is already magnified it by 10, you know? And so, you know, like, sometimes it's weird, but, like, I don't know. Him getting that job was, like, such a fucking powerful moment for me. It was because I literally, like...
Yeah?
Yeah. I know, I'm all over the place right now. I don't...
I'm listening. I'm loving it. I had a very rough weekend. Brenna had a baby, so I'm really enjoying
it. Okay, good. But, yeah.
Just because he found something where someone would pay for his skill.
Yeah, and it's what he wants to do, and it's what he loves. And I think...
It's out there.
Yeah, and our friends kind of take that sometimes as we want to hang out, and it's like, no, I just recognize that I need to get my act, like, going now, you know, like, and, you know, so that's been a thing that
there's
always...
room for both.
Exactly.
There's room for smoking and playing video games, and there's room for your own personal successes.
Exactly. And, like, I'm not bad mountain any of it, like, Whedon. I literally just play Minecraft before I came over here.
I love it. And life is too stressful to, like, go up, like, your child, inner child, you know?
Oh, yeah.
You definitely
And it's
that.
An escape, too, right? Like, it's like, people like to read books, but, like, if I find, like, a good story, like, a video game or Minecraft, it's, like, peaceful music, and it's, like, I can just look at it and zone out.
Minecraft does have
peaceful music. I love that game.
yeah, I've been obsessing over The Sims recently.
Uh-huh. I just bought all... the whole Sims collection.
Oh, really?
On my computer, yeah. Because, like, I don't know why they haven't made a new one. You know, like...
They need to. They're just coming out with expansion packs, I guess.
Yeah, which makes sense. There's a lot of money in that. But yeah. Come on, dog.
No, they need to make the Sims 5 or something.
Exactly. Those types of games I kind of gravitate towards nowadays. Like, just where it's like low effort, or not like low, it's casual. That's what they call it. It's casual gaming and stuff like that. I don't want to play like League of Legends where I'm just, my heart's palpitating and just like getting mad at some kid for being too good at the game.
They're vicious on there.
Yeah, they're fucking rude.
I follow some gamers on TikTok and they. They're pretty bad on there. I don't think I could do that.
There's nothing. The gaming community is toxic as fuck.
So sad.
Mm-hmm. It's like gamers unite and shit like that. Have you ever heard of that shit?
Yeah.
Like, just like wicked misogyny and like. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yeah, it's crazy. People want to rage.
Oh, yeah. Play games.
Yeah. So Claire is the person that you were that lives here.
Yeah.
That you were just in.
Yeah. And they are a geologist.
Oh, cool.
Which was really neat. They
That is neat.
Basically.
I have some extra numbers.
Okay.
Thank you. They're super fun.
Yeah, that's awesome. Are those acrylics or?
Yeah. My girlfriend.
Oh, yeah.
You want to take a picture?
Yeah, of course.
She bought them for me.
No way.
Yeah.
Hell yeah.
Yeah, she bought Jade and I gifts to get our nails done for our birthday.
Oh.
She's got them.
Yeah. What's their name?
Her name's Sneha. That's her. We met.
Oh, hell yeah. I feel like
first month of, I just posted that.
Yeah.
We met, first day of Pride.
Oh, no way.
Yeah.
That's beautiful. We're wearing a similar hat, I
think. Yeah. Exactly like that. Mm-hmm.
Right?
Those hats are cool.
Yeah.
Atlas, rimless.
I'm a beanie kind of gal. And
yeah.
But it's way too hot in the summertime. Yeah. So there's like, a lot of but anyways, that's awesome. So you met the first day of Pride.
Yeah.
And it's been going good.
She's pretty awesome. She's making me fall in love with Arizona too.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's awesome. I love Arizona.
I like it there.
I didn't even mention this to you, but my dad lived there.
Oh, really?
Yeah, and so I spent a lot of time, like.
Where?
He lived in Scottsdale.
Uh-huh.
And then Scottsdale and pretty much that area. In Sedonia, I think, is in Arizona, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, where all like the weird fucking tech hippies are now.
Yeah. Yeah, Brian and I have a weird aunt that lives out in there somewhere.
Yeah, he lived all like, is the bio, the actual biodome there too, right?
The what?
Yeah, what is it called? It's like, you know the movie Biodome? And if you don't, you need to watch that movie. Biodome is like a Pauly Shore movie.
Okay.
And it's with one of the Baldwin brothers who, like a quintessential fucking 90s movie.
Okay.
And they get stuck in Biodome. With a bunch of scientists, and they're like these like 90s stoner dudes, and they have to spend a year with them locked in this facility.
Oh shit.
Yeah.
In the middle of the desert, yeah. How
yeah, funny. This is the biodome failure. Biosphere is what it's called, and it's in Arizona. But basically, I'm trying to get a picture of it. So it's like a giant where they like different climates and stuff. They'll like have rainforest desert, and it's like to see. I think it was originally to see if we could like build space bases where we could grow, like simulate. But anyways, there's these little artist mud colony like earth ship things, and my dad lived there for a very long time. And there's like the artist colony community, just like. Yeah, you know, like literally like shady hippie people, but you know, that was what my dad was, that kind of person. Maybe not shitty, but he was definitely like, yeah. I mean, he died at 70, so I have remembered that. And yeah, no, he.
I just forgot about him. I'm sorry.
It was like I moved
fact, I moved to Denver, and the other reason was because, like, my dad lived in Denver for a long time. He lived everywhere. It's fucking weird, but... And so I kind of wanted, like, one of the many things was to, like, come back and, like, put myself in space. Like, his apartment that he lived in is, like 2 blocks that way.
Oh, he lived in this area, too.
Yeah.
That's cool.
Yeah, and so... And that's been a really neat, kind of, like, beautiful experience, and, like, walking around and just, like, you know, like, cause I don't have a traditional job anymore, so, like, I have a lot of free time. And so, I just sort of go and walk to, like, these places I remember going to with him and stuff like that. It's like very healing and stuff like that. But yeah, it's never what you expect it to be. And, it, you know, it's sad, and I miss him a lot. But at the same time, like, I don't know how to, like, say this, like, some people take this the wrong way, but, like, there was a weird sense of relief when he passed, because he also struggled a lot with mental health and alcoholism and stuff like that. So, and he'd gotten really sick and was, like, super scared of COVID and stuff like that, and just, like, the world in general, like, you know, that Trump was still around. That was one thing that was weird. I was like, I wish you would have, like, just stuck it out for another month to, like, see the election go through, you know? But, you know, like, this last year, like, probably from the beginning of COVID to now, was probably, like, the most, like, genuinely, like, transforming and, like, if for everyone, you know, like, but, like, creatively, like, emotionally, like, mentally, like, all of it, like, because he died and moved to Denver, broke up with this girl, it was very toxic, it became very toxic, their name's Gwen, and, you know, like, they, the one thing though is, like, they were there, like, we had only been seeing each other for, like, 3 weeks when he died, and she was like, I got the phone call, and I'll love her forever for that, because, like, having somebody there in that moment, you know, like, genuinely, like, at that time, I had my one roommate, Ben, who's, like, the most, like, antisocial person, so, to the point where, like, he would be missing for 3 days, and I knock on his door to make sure he's not dead, and then 19-year-old Brandon, who's, like, the most, like, emotionally mature person I've met at that point, so I, like, was very grateful for that, but when
that's
it came
to, right?
Yeah, I was living with, like, a 19-year-old boy, and a 24-year-old man. Ben was great, but it was a nice house, you know, it was nice. Yeah, like, she was there for me, and, like, was super supportive and stuff like that, but it became, like, when I moved here, it started getting more stressful, and there was parts of it that, like, I started to realize, I was like, oh, I'm not, like, dealing with my dad's death, I'm using this relationship in some, like, way to distract myself. And because I would just keep getting stuck in these, like,
ruts. Very self-aware.
Yeah.
It's a great skill to have.
Yeah. It can be a blessing and a curse, because it can be hypercritical.
That's true.
So, the therapy, that's a big part of it, too. But yeah, so, like, Gwen just, like, needed a lot more from me, and I think I was, like, really able to give, you know? Like, basically just, like, she was, like, so she, like, she's on the spectrum, autism, very mild. And so, like, one thing that was kind of hard sometimes, and like we worked on it actually made me a better communicator, is like sometimes like I'd have to explain things to her upon her request. And if I explain like there'd be certain like social media nuances that would have to miss, but they also like just needed to like be around me 24/7, and like I need my like alone time. That's like why Brenna and I work so well together.
She needs her.
Yeah, we're just like okay, like
introverted extrovert.
Exactly.
You need both. It's a balance.
Yeah, exactly.
And it's hard to have someone to balance.
Yeah.
I did that with the theater a lot.
Yeah, I mean, but you learn that, like, right? I've done that with relationships too, like, where I'm just like, because, like, for me, like, with addiction issues, like, I've had relationships where I realized.
How are you doing? I'm good. I just ate my lunch. I was joking that, like, it was kind of kind of a bold move for me to, like, show up for the first time by myself and be like, I brought a lunch.
You're good. No, that's what I'm doing. Right, we have, like, mix and match of everything. Strawberries,
I was going to, like, I feel like the only relationship that our taught is important.
Go get it.
but it's so nice to just hang here.
Yeah, you're with friends now.
You should join our Discord.
Oh, you don't have Instagram,
right? I don't have Instagram, but like, the normal still kind of stalks me on Instagram.
Yeah. Well, if you have your friend message me, I will send her them.
Her, yeah.
Okay. Her the Discord link, and then you can join.
Yeah, we're talking about some detail, like there was a big rift between her and she has a twin sister
whole questions,
and her friend
is like, we have a whole thing for shoes, for outfits,
like everybody I meet wants a tattoo for this girl, and I'm like, they all love her. She's a nice girl, but like, low-key, like, they are very toxic people, and like, gaslighting and stuff like that, and so what happened, like, basically, long story short, is just started saying that I was like manipulating Brian and stuff like that.
Yeah,
and,
like, they do.
Using her. And it was just like, I was like, oh fuck, like, I started like going into my, like, because that's never who I've been. I've never been like a fucking, you know, and I'm like, so I, like, maybe I'm subconsciously doing shit like that. I'm not realizing it's manipulating her, like, and so. Once again, like, to go back on it, like, hypercritical to myself, and that raised
the
my attention up and anxiety.
Like, yeah.
But then it became
so
very
like
apparent,
different types,
like,
of pole. What I usually that, do is, like, pole dancing,
example,
which is, like, the art form.
When
there's
you
also
go out
of the way
to spend
like
time
a
with me,
sport pole,
and
pole,
I had to almost beg her to hang out with her.
And then there's,
and that's what was so, like,
pole,
concerning and upsetting.
A
was,
lot
like,
of floor work
actively,
is
like, because I've been in relationships where my partner's, like, when I was younger and dumber, like, where, like, my partner's would be, like, I don't want you guys to hang out. Like, I almost lost my friendship with Taylor because of this girl, Megan, when we were, like, 19. Like, I was, like, in such a toxic thing. So I was very apparent, like, friends are important. Like, the day you say, like, I can't hang out with friends, is like, I'm out. I'll never do that. So, like, it was very confusing. And there was one night in particular, like, Gwen invited me to her house. And I was like, yeah, like, I'll come by. And that's, like, I still live in Lafayette at that time, so, like, that was a commute. And I go all the way there by the lift, and I walk in, and it's Gwen, her sister, and Lucy. And I'll never forget Lucy and, like, Viridian staring at me like I just, like, killed their family. And I was like, what the fuck? Like, and it was a very confusing situation to walk into. And then I come to find out that I guess Gwen had planned a girls' night with them. And then, like, last second, like, invited me and threw me into the situation. I had no idea I was walking into. I would have never done that if I knew. And so stuff like that, you know. And it just became extremely toxic. And, you know, like, basically, like, yeah, I was just, like, fucking just dumb, and we got in a fight, and, like, you know, like, over the phone, and it was, like, hung up, and, like, we just, I still haven't talked to him to this day. And, but it left me, like, feeling at that time, like, my self-worth, and, like, I mean, because, like, I didn't get, because I would try to be, like, hey, there's obviously an issue with you and your sister and your friend. Like, we should all just meet up and talk about it, because I feel like there's a massive misunderstanding, and she wouldn't let me talk to her. She's like, that's not gonna happen. And I'm like, well, like, because I knew, like, I was like, oh, if we just explained that that was a miscommunication, like, this, like, blah, 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 like, I'm pretty sure we can figure it out, because I love them. Like, I love fucking Meridian a lot. Like, she was my homie. And so, yeah, no, it just basically, I got stonewalled and, like, you know, so, with hearing that, like, I was this manipulative person and not being able to, like, explain myself and help, like, talk to them and, like, hey, this is my understanding. And, like, that left me just done, like, really broke up. In my apartment, I didn't have internet, I didn't have TV, like, I had been there for a month without internet. Like, I was struggling. And so, yeah, like, I was in, like, probably the darkest place. I was like thinking about, like, because my dad died accidentally. It was an accident in his apartment. And I started having this thought
for
He was in Hollow Springs. Like I said, he's been everywhere, but his final years. He lived here and was doing really, like, rough alcohol-wise and just, like, mentally. And he had early onset Alzheimer's. Like, and so my sister was in college still. And so I basically, at, like, 17, maybe even 18, I had to move my father all the way to Colorado to my own. And we found him a nice apartment, and then he started staying there, and then my sister got pregnant and had Everly in the first year. And then, you know, so he got to, like, it was beautiful. Like, his last year is, like... Yeah, like, it was, like, you know, like, in a weird way, like, it is beautiful. Like, it was good timing in the sense of, like, he didn't die with anybody, like, hating him or him, like, upset. Like, because he used to help take care of my niece and nephew. And that was like a second shot for him. He always felt that guilt of like leaving and stuff like that. And like, even like, he got invited to like Christmas and Thanksgiving with my parents, which like the last time I saw them in the room, you know, like it was in a courtroom, you know? So like everything was like just perfect and he was happy, you know? And so like, it, like that's like the things that I think, you know, like, you become more grateful for as long as like, you're not coming back. Like, you know, you really fucking weird if you came back. I'd be a little uncomfortable. But yeah, like, anyway, so I was left in this apartment and he lived alone and I was like, oh, I'm just gonna die alone in this apartment like my dad did. And so I was like, well, you know, like I was just like, well, I'm not going to spend the next 50 years doing exactly this, so like, I, you know, like, I tried to paint myself. I haven't talked about this a lot of people. I love you too. Thank you for letting me talk about it. Thank you. We've talked about your a lot. Yeah, that's, it was, yeah, so like I went through that, and yeah, that was maybe March, February, and yeah, so like break up like all the shit, like not taking care of my mom, I was not facing my mom's death while I was in that relationship, because like, you know, it's like a very complex thing to digest, and like, so, you know, like basically all this kind of came up, and not having any internet, my phone was turned off, like,
that's crazy.
Yeah, and so I was extremely, like the most isolated I've ever been in my life. I had my cat, which was great, but at the same time, like, I didn't have, and I didn't know anybody, other, and like, I couldn't tell Serena, like, I didn't, like, it was a very dark period, but, like, it led to me getting admitted, and I got therapy and psychiatry, and I got diagnosed with stuff, and, like, so that's been, like, a really great thing, like, you know, like, my clinical depression, severe anxiety. I have memory-related, or trauma-related memory loss, which is something that was weird, because that was the other part, like, I can't even remember the day when I died.
Yeah.
Like, there's all these things that, like, when I was in that relationship with Gwen, like, she would bring up something that we talked about, and like, I'm pretty good at remembering shit, but like, I think it was from like that night or something, because like, there's a lot more to it than I was going to, but yeah, so like, I have to write stuff down now.
That's good.
Yeah.
That's good for you anyway.
Exactly. I think, I don't know what it is, but anyway.
Like, you just drop down like thoughts that you have? Or
yeah, just like things that I know, like, and it's gotten better. You know, I like do exercises and just like also just eat right and just try to take care of myself a little bit better. And so yeah, like I would forget like really major things, like, and like very important dates that I had to remember and stuff like that, and I kind of noticed that, and it became a part of contention with my relationship and my family and stuff like that. And so like I, like, I don't know, it was weird, like when I went and got, like when I talked to like my friends and stuff like that, like I went there twice in the very beginning, the second time like I like couldn't remember it, so they ran some tests and like basically they were like, yeah, we think that this isn't, you know, like, so it's not something I can necessarily like just like fix with medication or anything like that. It's just repetitive, like, so like say you're like, oh, I'm doing this thing, like just gonna say like I need to write that down and just like make sure that like I have so many little notebooks. Like I don't know where they are. Oh, here it is. This is a new one, so there's nothing in it, but these little tiny
that
numbers.
Cute.
Yeah.
This makes no sense.
But yeah. Like,
that's nice. It's eye-opening when you can find two of that.
Yeah. No, exactly. It's gotten way better.
We really have a good set up for success.
Well,
I was just talking to Dean about how I feel like our generation, although I think many, have not been set up for success, which is why we're not having kids. Although we're not doing the nuclear family for a lot of other reasons, but it's also because we're kind of still trying to recover
from the atmosphere. Exactly. Like, I should be, in my opinion, so going to therapy and psychiatry help a lot, you know, like that definitely helps.
It's like hard to be more like chemicals and
stuff like that. Yeah, and just like certain aspects of just like, how like basically imbalances and shit like that, which I'd had my entire life, like, and so yeah, like, it was just, like, I'd always heard, like, obviously people say that therapy and that's a very important thing, and you should if you need. Like, it doesn't work for everybody, but, like, people would talk about going to therapy, like, you know, just, like, getting diagnosed with, like, this, like, free, like, for some people that was such a sense of relief, and for me it was, because, like, okay, I now know what things are, because there'd be years of me just, like, being hyper-critical of myself and being like, why don't I do that? Like, was this, like, what's wrong with me, blah, blah, blah.
And to be able to... Almost like you can't see the reality of it.
Exactly, so to have, like, something that, like... Exactly, like, okay, these are the things I have to work on, it was, like, one of the most freeing moments. So, yeah, long story short, like I said, this last, like, year and a half, probably, like, the most emotionally, mentally, like, even physically, like, transformative.
Transformative.
It is wild. And just, like, caring about people more.
Yeah,
exactly, of course. Forever and always.
Anarchy. All the stuff in between.
But yeah, like, I definitely think our generation kind of got lucky, but I think also our generation's I think our generation recognizes that, and we're hopefully going to set up.
I'm going to bounce.
Oh, hey, okay. Thank you so much for
thank you. Did you have fun? So, I had the best time. So nice to hang here.
Yeah, I'm seeing a lot of
I would love to. I would absolutely love to. Yeah. No worries. I can come to the scenes. I want to hear what you're
saying. I love that. I'm thinking we're going to have a studio space for us to do this. Like, I think I said that in the winter.
Very cool.
I want to have, like, a little book library. Yeah. So I'm going to put it in there.
Coming back to
fantastic.
So wonderful.
I don't know. I feel
like I feel so great.
Yeah,
and I think coming back here and hanging out with my friends.
Bailey, was super nice to meet you.
Hi, it was so nice to meet you. I hope you come next, not next Sunday, but Sunday.
Yeah, Sunday afterwards.
I'll be looking out on TikTok for you.
Yeah.
Enjoy.
Yeah, thank you.
See you soon.
Bike safe.
Join our Discord group.
I will. It was so nice to meet you all.
I make friends really easily, but I think it's because I like to be a people pleaser. Mm-hmm. And I think the fact I'm a people pleaser, I like don't know what my personality is because I'm just constantly thinking about what people want from me. Should I be loud? Because I am a loud person. I feel like that loudness is because I want everyone to be happy. I don't know. And gender expression is a new thing. Being with a woman is very new.
Yeah.
And, like, I don't know. I just feel like I am finding out my standards, and it's kind of hard when some of my friends don't meet those standards anymore, and I don't want them to be my friends. And I don't like them.
That's a part about growing up. Yeah. And, like, who I am is, like, such an intense and powerful, like, question. Right. Like, you know.
Especially in society when they put us in boxes already.
Exactly.
And that's super frustrating. And which is why the gender conversation is so fun to have, because it breaks apart those rules.
Exactly.
Like, you know, I think about things much differently now.
Right. And that's fucking beautiful. It sounds like you're so on your way, you know? It takes time. We'll figure it out.
I feel like coming back here, I've come back twice now.
Uh-huh.
And I don't mind coming back. I miss Denver a lot. I love it. And there's a lot of people that I miss seeing. Mm-hmm. But I need to be intentional with who I want to see.
That's a big part of it. Because there are certain people, like, I've had to, like, kind of the same exact thing, like you said, like, where I'm like, this is not, like, healthy for either of us, and it's not, like, I don't want to be treated this way, or, like, you know, like, and stuff like that, you know, like,
I have friends that will be like, oh, you don't hang out anymore, but then like they won't even think about making the effort to try to hang out with you. I don't have a car. And they all live in Erie and Denver, or in Boulder. Like, it's not that easy for me to get there, but like stuff like that, and just like learning what like manipulative, like toxic kind of things is, just like you said, like figuring out the standards and realizing that like that's not healthy for me. And it's not a selfish thing. It took me years to realize that. I was like, oh, it would be selfish, because like I want to make people happy too, you know, like that. I learned that, like, I was like always helping everybody else, going out of my way, like breaking my back to help these people I care about, which is good, but I just would never leave anything for me, you know. And so yeah, that's just like a sad part, but that also like makes those bonds that you still have with the people that you do like love and meet those standards, like being stronger, you know. Like, that's awesome. Like,
help you get it.
Like,
it
sounds like, yeah, you're on your way.
Yeah.
You know?
Brenna was my savior.
Brenna saved me too.
You guys can call me Jesus from now on.
Well,
Jesus.
Yeah.
Hi, white lady Jesus.
Jesus saves.
Yeah. Or white savior, that's fine too.
Did you tell your sister what you were saying like all Friday night? Like,
oh, sussy bussy?
Yeah,
yeah, she's been saying
don't worry.
All weekend.
Literally, I'd be like talking to customers or to people and just like hear it every time.
It was literally just the end of the night though, because this crew came over and they were like feeding me on too much.
And honestly, your reaction was feeding me on too.
Yeah, no, it's because like I could be like having a serious conversation and I just hear that and I would lose my shit in front of the person.
Yeah.
Sassy bastard. I know. And
yes, and Bailey wore yours last night. I'm gonna give you one. It's also a submissive
wearer. Yeah, I broke it in for you.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Perfect.
I'm gonna wash it.
Oh, you don't have to wash it.
It's blue. It's really cute. Please don't wash it.
Please don't wash it.
Take all my dead skin cells.
You just wear it the rest
sweat.
Of the weekend. You know.
Yeah.
No big deal.
Yeah,
sure.
But doesn't it look so good?
Yeah, I like the yellow. So
yellow's fun.
The fucking Bigelow soap logos.
Yeah, I was hoping it would still show up, and it does. And then the back has...
Oh, hell yeah.
Yeah.
No,
so hopefully it sells some stuff. I was kind of hoping people would notice it today, but no one's said anything today. So.
I should have worn it.
It's okay.
Yeah, no. I feel like...
These people aren't who I want to sell to. Like, I would love to, but these are my...
Yes. Yeah,
they don't need to.
Oh, there's a little bit smaller of a class
over and
today.
Over again. Yeah, I think it's because it's Labor Day.
That's
I was kind of worried that we would have too many people today because of First Friday.
Mm-hmm.
Everyone was like, yeah, I want to come. And then, yeah, I think it's Labor Day.
I think that happens a lot, you know. Like, cause it's like a fun thing. Like,
yeah, dude,
yeah.
Everyone here is so chill. I love everyone. So
that's why I come hang out here, just because like, it's not like, it's a very like safe
space.
Where it's like,
sometimes hard to fucking come back.
Exactly.
Yeah.
And it's like extremely inclusive and like normally like I mean I still don't go do the poll very often. But like the first time I did, like it was like the first time doing like a learning an activity in front of a bunch of people and like in a circle around.
Oh, yeah. What a girl, somebody. Baby, can you see? I'm calling. A guy like you should wear a warning. It's dangerous. I'm falling. There's no escape. Getting late to give you up. I took a sip from my devil's cup. Don't you know that you're toxic?
Yeah. I had a Mustang in my first class up in the sky. Pop a champagne, living my life in the fast lane. I wanna change by the glamorous. Caviar drinking beans. You deserve nothing but all the finer things. Now this whole world has no clue what to do with us. I got enough money in the bank for the two of us. Plus I gotta keep enough lettuce to support your shoe fetish lifestyle. So rich and famous, Robin Leach will get jealous. Half a million for the stove, taking trips from here to Rome. So if you ain't got no money, take your broke ass home.
The glamorous, the glamorous, the glamorous. I'm just a girl. Can I make it any more obvious?
that we the shit. F-R-E-S-H, we fresh. G-E-F, that's right, we different. Right. We definite. B-E-P, we reppin' it. So, turn me up. Come on, baby, just pump it. Check this out right here. Dude wanna hate on us. Dude need to ease on up. Dude wanna act on gut, but dude get shut like Flavin' Chuck. Chick say she ain't down with chick backstage when we in town. She like men on drums. She wanna hit and run. Yeah, that's the speed. That's what we do. That's who we be. B-L-A-C-K-E-Y-A-D-D to the E, then the A to the S. When we play, you shake your ass. Shake it, girl. Make sure you don't break it, girl. Cause we gonna turn it up. Come on, baby, just pump it.
gone, your bones are all alone. So take off your coat, put a song in your throat, let the dead beats pound all around. We will go nowhere we know, we don't have to talk at all. Hand me downs, fly paper towns, stuck together, one and all. The bargains you drive, buckets and bags, and all your belongings. Your train's in the sand, a ramshackle land that the rats watch.
You leave yourself behind.